This is the man who put a million on black, and it came up black. This is the man who married a sex kitten, and she's still purring. This is the man who moved into gold, just before all the clever money moved in as well. This is the man who is chauffeured around in an S-Class Mercedes-Benz. People at the very top, presidents not only of international companies, but of whole countries, travel S-Class. And to make sure they aren't swayed toward BMW or Cadillac, Mercedes has just spent $1 billion turning what was once the best car in the world into what damn well ought to be the best car in the world. This is the S-Class for the 21st century, and it's new in every respect. New body, new suspension, new engine options, new heights of luxury, and a new dietary problem. It's more than 17 feet long, and this, the £85,000 range topper, weighs more than 2 tons. Mercedes are obviously expecting some kind of environmental backlash on this front. So they're talking at some length about how they hardly use any CFCs while making it, how they use water-based paint, how they've stopped using tropical wood, and how a large part of it is made out of recycled bits and bobs. Just think, this whole car was once probably a Volkswagen Polo, or three. But El Presidente is not going to buy it just because it's nice to the trees. He'll want to know what it's like back here, and he won't be disappointed. Even if he's a very large El Presidente, he's going to fit. It is vast. Now, Muggins up front, he's got plenty of toys and buttons to play with, what with his electric rear-view mirror and his fold-away exterior mirrors. But I haven't been forgotten either. I've got electric seats, and they really do recline. They're heated, of course, and there's electric lumbar support as well. And then there's the rinky-dinky little mirrors in the roof, and my own air conditioning controls, and they work 20 minutes after the engine has been turned off. You can specify air suspension, but quite frankly, I don't see the point. The ride is absolutely superb, not so firm that a fat Presidente will wobble, and not so squidgily that he'll arrive at his gin palace feeling car sick. Now, there was no way Mercedes were going to let Jaguar and BMW strut about the world offering people V12 engines when they, the people that invented the motor car in the first place, could only offer a V8. This is their answer. It's got a V12 engine, 6 litres, 48 valves, one of the most sophisticated engine management systems we've ever seen, and a 7 litre catalytic converter. That's bigger than the engine. It's too complicated for me. What I do understand is that it develops 408 horsepower. That's as much as the Grand Prix cars of a few years ago. I definitely want to go. Could you go and buy a paper?
What a wicked game to play to make me feel this way. What a wicked thing to do. Let me dream of you. What a wicked thing to do.
The last time Mercedes made a V12 engine, it was fitted in the front of a Messerschmitt fighter. They must be hoping to attract a rather different clientele this time around, and they will succeed. There's only one word to describe that box of tricks under the bonnet. Thirsty. I mean, magnificent. It can propel this 2.2-ton monster from 0 to 60 in 6 seconds. Now, for the leaders of smaller countries like Canada, there are smaller engines, one with 6 cylinders and 2 superb V8s. There's also a standard-sized body designated SE. This, of course, is the long-wheelbase SEL. However, none is the aesthetic masterpiece you might have expected for $1 billion. But all of them, and this one in particular, justifies its price through sheer attention to detail. Engage reverse and 2 little aerials glide out of the rear wings, helping drivers to see the far-flung corners.
That's quite clever, isn't it? And you should see this. Put my hand in the way, and it stops. And that's not the end of their repertoire. It's got double glazing. Now, is this a gimmick? I don't think it is. You can't steam the windows up because there's a vacuum in between, and it makes the car quieter. And if you think that's clever, look at this. Self-closing doors. No more slamming to wake the neighbours. And there are some clever little touches around the back, too. You know what it's like when the back of the car's all covered in muck and you've got to open up the boot. Not with the Merc, you don't. And even this self-closes as well. And to round it all off, you can't even forget to close the windows. Operate the remote central locking, and they shut themselves. There is so much to enjoy about this car. It somehow seems a shame to waste my time driving it. Dennis. Dennis, I want to go home now. No, now, Dennis, now.
Well, I must say, it's nice to catch that glimpse of Nice. And incidentally, for children watching, please don't put your hands inside the electric windows of your cars, because they almost certainly won't stop, as the Mercedes ones did.